This is the solution to quiz 5. Okay. So we're requested to integrate a piecewise defined function against the across an interval where the definition changes. So we'll have to break this into individual integrals. So this will be the integral from 1 to 3. And we'll have to integrate the first piece. So that would be 9 x squared plus 1 times x dx, and then plus the integral from 3 to 6, 4x plus 3 dx, and then plus the integral from 6 to 9, 7 dx. Okay, so that's splitting the integral into its individual pieces. So I'll leave this first one because it has a slight amount of intrigue. So I'll just copy it for now. So 1 to 3, and then 9x squared plus 1, x dx, and then plus. So for this middle one, I'll use the fundamental theorem. So that would be 2x squared plus 3x, this evaluated from 3 to 6, and then plus, well, this is just a rectangle. You can still use the fundamental theorem, 7x from 6 to 9, but this is a rectangle of height 7 and base 3, so the answer is just 21. So I'll leave this first integral one more time. So 1 to 3, 9, x squared plus 1, x dx, and then now I'll do the fundamental theorem for that part. I'll do the evaluation for that part. Okay, so that's what? 2 times 6 squared plus 3 times 6. Then minus 2 times 3 squared plus 3 times 3. Okay. So this would be plus 63 plus 21. Okay, now for this one, we'll need to do a substitution. So I'll say u is x squared plus 1. Then du would be 2x dx, but we don't need that 2, so I'll move it to the left-hand side as a division. Du over 2 is x dx, and I'll switch the limits. U evaluated at 1 is 2, and u evaluated at 3 is, look, I left off this cube this whole time. Cubed. U evaluated at 3 is 10. Okay, so then performing that, that would be what? So integral now 2 to 10, 9 u cubed differential part is du over 2. I'll combine these two together. This is what, 84, so plus 84. So the 9 halves can come outside. And then that's u to 4 over 4. From 2 to 10. So that would be 9 over 8. And then, what, 10 to 4 minus 2 to 4? Plus 84. Okay, so 10 to 4, oops, 9 over 8 times 10 to 4 minus 2 to 4. So that's 1, 2, 3, 2. And then plus 84. Is 11,316. So that's the answer to part one. Okay, so question two. So part A. In the end, we're requested to evaluate integral 0 to 20 of 300 exponential negative 0.2 t dt. So that's integrating the derivative over the interval in question. Okay, well, this would be 300 and then exponential negative 0.2 t divided by negative 0.2 and then evaluating this from 0 to 20. So I'll go ahead and do 300 over 0.2, that's 1500. And then I'll use this negative to switch the order of evaluation. And then plugging that in, 1500 times 1 minus the exponential of negative 0.2 times 20. So to the nearest integer, 147, well, the exact answer is 1472.526542. At least that's what my calculator is able to give. And therefore, to the nearest integer, 1472, to the nearest integer, 73. Okay, so B. So now, instead of integrating from 0 to 20, we're asked to integrate from 0 to big T. So big T is replacing 20. But otherwise, this is exactly the same. So we can just sort of look at the work that we did before. That would be 1500 exponential negative 0.02 little t, and then evaluated from big T to 0. Doing that, you obtain 1500, and then multiplied by 1, because that's that thing evaluated at 0, and then minus exponential of 0.02 big T. So that's m of t. Okay. Then part C. In the end, we're asked to compute that value. So the limit as big T goes to infinity of that value, 15,000, 1 minus exponential negative 0.02 big T. Well, that's 1500. 1500 goes to 1500, 1 goes to 1, and then that goes to 0. So the answer is 1500. So it wasn't requested in this exercise, but just as a matter of explanation, what's happening here is that this horizontal axis is time, and this is, this horizontal axis will be big T. This will be m of big T. And there is an asymptote up here at 1500. Number of messages received by this account, so it is starting at 0 and then quickly gets up here and then decays. So that's the number of messages received. So visually, you know, maybe right here, maybe this is 20 days. At 20 days, 1,473 have been received. Okay, and then number 3. Okay, so then so part A, give a rough sketch. So this first one is a parabola that opens up. This is a line that slopes up. And this one is a vertical line. So let's see how the red and the green intersect. So how do this and this intersect? Well, there's 3 possibilities. Could be like this, or this, so like this one, or like this one, or like this one. That is to say, they intersect twice, once, or zero times. So, to determine which one, we'll solve the equation parabola equal line. So then x squared minus 4x plus 18 equal to 3x. 3x. Plus 8, so that would be x squared minus 7x plus 10 equal to 0. This factors into x minus 2 times x minus 5 equal to 0. So then there are two solutions, 2 and 5. As a result, it tells us is that first scenario. So therefore, the picture is a parabola that has two intersections. One of them is occurring at x is 2, the other one is occurring at x is 5, and now we've got one more line at x is 6. And looking at that picture, there's two different pieces that are bounded. So what's being referred to is this and this. So there's two pieces. So for part B, the integral formula for this, so this would be integral 2 to 5 that is to say in this region, and it should look like line minus parabola dx, because the line is higher up, and then integral 5 to 6, and in this case it will be parabola minus line plus. So that's to say that that this region right here corresponds to the first integral, and this region, the second integral. So if we give these regions names, region 1 and this one, region 2, I'll integrate them separately up here. So for region 1, the integral is 2 to 5. And then if you do line 3x plus 8 minus parabola, x squared minus 4x plus 18 dx, that is integral 2 to 5 negative x squared plus 7x minus 10 dx. We can use the fundamental theorem. So that would be negative x cubed over 3, and then plus 7 halves x squared minus 10x and evaluated from 2 to 5. So now we can evaluate this expression. So that would be negative 125 over 3 plus, 7 times 20 times 25 plus 175 over 2 minus 50 and then minus negative 8 over 3, plug in 2, one of the 2's cancels, so that'll be plus 14 and then minus 20. So now we can combine all of those. So that's negative 125 and then plus 8 is negative 117 over 3. And then 14 minus 20 is negative 6, but we're subtracting it, so that's negative 50 plus 6. So that's minus 44. And then plus 175 over 2, so 175 over 2. 87 and a half, and 117 over 3 is 39, so that's negative 39 minus 44 plus 87 and a half, so that's 4.5. So that first region has area 4.5, and the second region, well, that will be integral 5 to 6, and it will be reversed, that is to say, it will be parabola minus the line, and because it's parabola minus the line, after simplifying, that will be x squared minus 7x plus 10 dx, and then that will be x cubed over 3 minus 7 halves x squared plus 10x. And then this evaluated from 5 to 6 Okay, so plugging these things in. So 6 cubed over 3. That's 72. Minus 7 times 6 squared over 2. So minus 126. Then plus 60, then minus, plug in 5, again that's 1, 2, 5 over 3, minus 175 over 2, and then plus 50. That first number, so adding up all the easy ones, so 72 minus 126 plus 60 and then plus 175 over 2 minus 50. So let's check that. So that gives 43.5 minus 125 over 3, and since this is not going to simplify any further, 43.5 times 3 is 130.5, so that's 130.5, and then divide by 3, minus 125 over 3, so that is 130.5 minus 125, 5.5. So that's the area of region 2. And therefore, the total area is 4.5 plus 5.5 over 3. So 3 times 4.5 plus 5.5 is 19 over 3.